Good evening, sports fans. Welcome to League 1, Season 15, Week 10. First off, we've got Clemson at number 1 ranked Syracuse. We're going to follow that up later tonight with Navy at Notre Dame. Notre Dame and Clemson, both good teams, both previously ranked during this season, but currently unranked. So a couple of real good games for you tonight. We're going to take a quick look here through the Clemson Tigers roster with the head coach of the Syracuse Orange, Coach Spectre. And then we're going to get kicked off, and later on we'll take a look at Navy and Notre Dame. So let's start with the Tigers. Coach?
Hello, League One aficionados. Coach Spectre here to give you an inside look at the Clemson Tigers this year, led by quarterback Hunter Johnson. He's a 92 with 83 speed, 94 agility, 94 acceleration. Coming in with a 16-3 touchdown to interception ratio and a 162 rating, he has been excellent this year for the Tigers. If he gets hurt, his backup, nearly a twin, in Zarek Cooper, also a 92. Halfback Travis Etienne, All-American, is back. He was a 99 last year, so he's got to be about 103 now, and he is a deadly weapon. Coming in about 75 yards a game this year, been out a couple of games, but he's back, and contributing additionally 41 yards through the air. So quite the weapon there for the Tigers. We'll be on the lookout for him. Chance Phillips at fullback is an 85. T. Higgins, Amari Rogers, and DeAndre Overton head up the wide receiver core. All three of them active with over 40 yards per game, although none over 70. They spread it out between the three of them. Freshman J.J. Green is the tight end. Not involved too much in the passing game, and we hope to keep it that way. Left to right, the offensive line is an 88, junior left tackle, an 89 senior left guard, a true freshman 76 at center with an 88 junior right guard and an 88 senior right tackle. Defensive end solid as well, an 87 on the left and an 85 on the right. Linebacking core behind the defensive tackles, Niles Pinckney in the NFL now. He's an 88 right now as a senior. Goodman backs him up at D tackle. The linebacking core, Shaq Smith is a 92. With 80 awareness, he'll be tough on the left side. Middle linebacker, a junior 83, and right outside linebacker, a senior 87. So a good solid B plus A minus linebacking core behind that front four. Secondary, AJ Terrell and Richard Bell lead the cornerback core, but we're hoping to take advantage of the slot corners in Barnes and Bailey. Santonio Bush at free safety is an 87, and Isaiah Simmons an 87 as well at strong safety. Special teams unit has an 89 sophomore and a 95 senior, so the kicking game quite solid for Clemson. This is a good football team with a lot of 90s, a lot of danger here. We're going to try to play a balanced game and get out to an early lead and see what we can do from there without turning the ball over. We will turn the microphone over to the voice of Syracuse football, Coach Ninja.
Thank you, Coach. And after having a quick look at the Clemson Tigers, we're ready to get kicked off. The Tigers are 4-3. But they are a 97 overall with a 99 offense and a 95 defense. Against a 99-99 Syracuse Orange, it is a battle of the teams that are orange and white. Clemson, the 40th in the country in points scored per game and the 33rd in the country in points against per game, both good numbers, the reason they have a winning record. But Syracuse is first in the country in points scored and 15th in points against. That's why they are number one and undefeated. Number very important prospects coming to visit, including the number one defensive end in the country, Ray Martinez, and Lyle Gates, the number 11 outside linebacker in the country, visiting this week. Top players, Tommy Tanuvasa, Mo Neal, and Adrian Anoisi, against Travis Etienne, the punter, Spears, and the halfback, Johnson. Injuries, we can see that the center has a sprained ankle, is probable, and will play. Wide receiver Chase has a broken collarbone and is out.
Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the
a calm, still day here inside the Carrier Dome. Hard to tell the visiting fans from the home fans. I'm sure that's of great comfort to the Syracuse Orange, imagining that there is no visiting side.
Storied legacies in the history of college football.
I started my coaching career, I had a dream. And every decision that I made, that I will be the head football coach of Syracuse University. Undefeated, untied.
1959 national champions.
Syracuse has scored an undefeated season, and the team carries Ben Schwartzwalder off the field.
It's gonna be the greatest victory that you kids have ever had.
Dozens of the most prolific and impactful players in the game. The first African American to win the Heisman Trophy. 6 members of the Pro Football Hall of Fame. 53 All-America selections.
We need to make this place the hardest place to play in the country. We need you. We need everyone. This is our state, our town, our team, and we gotta win now. Go Orange!
Spanning more than 10 successful seasons and covering the country from California, Ohio, North Carolina, and Virginia, this is League One NCAA football.
Don't you let anyone steal history away from you.
Since 1889, this is Syracuse football.
Travis Etienne taking the knee at the top of the A in Syracuse in the end zone. And they come out with 11 personnel. The tight end's behind the guard and the tackle. Green falls at the feet of the quarterback, causes a throwaway by Hunter Johnson. Good rush there by Green. Tight end right, halfback left. Etienne tries getting outside to the right. He is trapped out in the flat after a 7-yard gain. Good run blocking there from the line, but couldn't get past the second layer, the linebackers.
Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense.
Quarterback and halfback under center now, or behind center, I should say. Tight end motions from left to right. Higgins on a slant over the middle, 13 yards.
This is a quarterback who trusts his receivers, and he knows they can make plays. It's like those two were playing.
The Tigers go hurry up. Halfback weak, tight end right, close to the left hash. 4 down linemen for the defense. And it's another quick throw out of bounds for Johnson. Tight end comes off the field. It's going to be four wide receivers and a single halfback for the Tigers. The Orange keep four down linemen and three linebackers. It's a spread pistol. It's an out route to Lance Beck, 20 yards, and a foot out of bounds, the gap between the defenses. No huddle again from the Tigers. Etienne breaks the tackle, gets first down, gets nine more. Able to evade in space to the outside. A little hurry up and wait here from the Tigers. Hunter doesn't seem to know what he's trying to do. Looks like, yes, they don't get the playoff. That's a penalty. Now, they're coming out in an interesting formation. Must be that tight end or that fullback, one of them's playing a line. And it's a quick pass to the fullback, but he gets taken down after a four-yard gain. J.J. Green out in the flat as the tight end playing fullback there. And hurry up, second and 11. And Beck does a route, makes a cut just before the end line, finds space, takes it over the line.
You got to give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
Great way to find a gap in the defense there by Beck. Big game there in the Pac-12. Stanford staying ahead, 8-1, keeping their head in it. Schumacher, 3 yards into the end zone. He tries to break left. He's at the 30. Gets hit out of bounds about the 35-yard line. And here comes Heisman leader Tommy Tanuvasa to start the game.
And when your star quarterback feels good playing at home and he gets off to a good start, some big things can happen for this offense.
Five wide receivers for the Orange to begin the game. Three down linemen for the Tigers. Tanuvasa in the pocket waits for Lofton on the drag to get in front of his left guard. And then passes. Lofton then turns upfield, gets another 5 yards to make it second and one. Great start of the game for Syracuse. Second and short, every coach's favorite down and distance.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
The Orange come out in the eye. There's four down linemen. Looks like four linebackers as well. At least four guys up close to the line of scrimmage. The handoff to Mo Neal, running left. They call it a 1 yard rush to third and inches as a safety, it looks like, came down to help against the run. More traditional 4-3 stack here. as you see from the defense. And this time it's a handoff to the fullback, Tyrell Richards. He gets 2 yards and a first down on the early handoff. It's first and 10 now on their own 47 for the Orange. Shotgun ace twins, two tight ends either side of the line, single halfback. Lofton comes in motion from the left slot. Tanuvasa is running up the seam. He gets a 9-yard rush, and once again, the Orange at second and short. Shotgun normal, halfback weak from just inside the right hash. It's a quarterback keeper. Tanuvasa's running left. He's getting outside. And the safety peels off of his, sorry, that should be the corner, peels off of an excellent run block that got an extra 5 yards. Great run blocking by both the slot receiver and the sideline receiver there on the left side of the field for the Orange to get the big gain on the read option. It's now first and 10 from the opponent's 22. Tanuvasa scrambles out of the pocket on first and 10. He gets a 9-yard scramble. Runs in headlong, and it's again second and 1 for the third time. This time, though, Tanuvasa looks a little winded. Shotgun spread flex. The handoff is to Mo Neal. It's a 4-yard gain. It's now first and 10 from the 9. It's first down. They'll be looking for 6 points here. 5 wide receivers and 3 down linemen. At first and goal from the 9, Tanuvasa scrambles out, doesn't like all of his looks, runs upfield, gets some delayed run blocking there, as finally Lofton peels off of his route to actually run the block. Eventually, he has to bounce off the sideline first. Peels off the sideline to get in somebody's route. Doesn't really block, but great scramble there by Tanuvasa for the touchdown. We'll be tied with the extra point. Just over halfway through the first, and we have a tie ball game as it's now Tiger ball once again.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out.
Interesting formation here, and it's a quick pass into the flat for Tim Arnold. No gain out of the pistol short house. From their own 24-yard line. This time, two halfbacks on the field. This is a shotgun split, 3 wide receivers. Johnson attempts the pass into the flat and causes a couple of defenders to miss on Tim Arnold, the second halfback. It's a 12-yard gain and no huddle. Looks like Arnold is going to be playing the tight end this time. And Higgins, on a quick slant, gets 7 yards as the defense is thinking run left. Arnold still playing fullback. And looks like either a fake or a failed handoff, but that's a loss of 5. Do they call that a sack? It doesn't look like it. But it is now 3rd and long. It takes 3.5 men to bring down Travis Etienne, but the 5-yard gain is 3 yards short. It's going to force a punt here from their own 43. It's a good defensive stand there from the orange. And Schumacher gets out from underneath it, lets it go into the end zone. Shotgun Y trips, looks like, here. Tanuvasa gets out of the pocket, scrambles right, and throws it to the receiver, bouncing off the sideline, but the defender gets a hand in, closing. It's now 2nd and 10. After a heads-up defensive play to get his fingers on the ball. Lofton in motion, right to left. Quarterback keeper up the seam. And a 9-yard gain for Tanuvasa. Makes it 3rd and 1.
Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. Come out in a 5-wide set. Caught, and he's hit immediately. Call it a gain of 1 yard.
That makes it 4th. Tipped ball falls forward, but not enough for the first down. It's 4th and inches from their own 30.
Is waiting for the snap. Gets it away, it's low.
And the punt is received, and a 12-yard return from Arnold gives solid field position to the Clemson Tigers.
So far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter.
The tight end in now at the fullback position. It's a handoff to Etienne. He dodges some defense. Dodges all of the defense. And that's a 49-yard touchdown run. And unfortunately, it seems like that's exactly what the defense was expecting, and they still couldn't do anything about it. Big game in the SEC, undefeated Virginia against Duke, helmed by the quarterback Daniel Jones, now a backup quarterback for the New York Football Giants after this year's NFL draft.
Clemson is lining up to kick this one off. He
Allworth, shallow in the end zone, takes it out, gets to the 19, 25-yard return, starting at the 23, there's going to be 30 seconds remaining in the quarter. Tanuvasa looks like he wants to scramble, then realizes the cornerback is blitzing. He's not going to have it, but sees the space for the deep route. When he gets a break on the defender with the move, heads up play for a big pass to midfield. And they now are on just the midfield stripe. Tanuvasa out of the pocket. And Anoisi is pressed there and slows down. And with 9 seconds left, they're going to hurry up. Try and get one more playoff. Shotgun wide trips. Pass to Mo Neal out of the backfield. It's 5 yards. Second and five now. To begin the second quarter. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Shotgun spread, offset, spread flex, I should say. Mo Neal in the backfield. This time he gets 5 yards on the ground. It's going to be first and 10. On the 15-yard line, it is now in the red zone. An empty midfield gives James Lofton all the space in the world to get 13 yards. It's first and goal now from the 2. They fake him out, but the blitzing linebacker slows him down but can't prevent Tommy Tanuvasa from crossing the line on the designed quarterback run out of the 5 wide for the touchdown.
Linebacker, a safety, somebody who's got great speed, who can account for the run.
When the East is in the house, oh my God.
Danger!
When the East is in the house,
oh my God.
When the East is in the house,
oh my God.
Danger!
When the East is in the house,
oh my God.
With an extra point and a touchback from Hoffrichter, it is now Tiger ball again. This time we see a pistol full house. Handoff is to Etienne, who was behind the quarterback. It's a 4-yard gain. Once again, the handoff is to Etienne. He's running outside to the right. And touchdown saving tackle after 35 yards. We continue to see hurry up. And it's play action. Rodgers gets the ball, sheds a tackler. It's 14 yards. Still in the full house. Hand off to Etienne. He heads upfield but bounces outside and is stopped after a gain of 3. Gain of two this time. It's third and five now for Clemson. They're on the 15-yard line. Sorry, 16-yard line. Third and five from the full house. Johnson, he breaks the pocket with the scramble, and he's going to get a touchdown. They were looking for the pass, and it wasn't there, but there was lots of green space for Johnson to run through.
And, he adds the extra point.
And once again,
we take you down to Dura. This is
the Tigers respond to the Orange, tying the game.
For Virginia, let's keep an eye on this game where a major surprise could be brewing. And for Ball, he snagged a couple of touchdown passes. The Blue Devils have the lead, 28-20. Expect that that score is going to hold, but boy, that would be an upset. Clemson ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of
Schumacher just inside the U. He breaks around, gets to the 29, and is hit out of bounds by number 47.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way
starting now on their own 29-yard line. Shotgun ace here. Loft in motion from left to right. Tanuvasa keeps and he runs way up the middle. It's a 7-yard gain to second and three. Almost ran straight up the gut there before he peeled out. The defense was waiting for him in the flat. The defense was nowhere to be seen when Mo Neal was making his break. He got 13 yards out of the backfield. Tommy Tanuvasa on the quarterback keeper. The defense on the left side of the field, one of them's pancaked. It's a big run. 46-yard gain there on the quarterback keeper out of the split big. First and goal now from the one. And Lofton on the drag route out of the middle slant catches it and brings it over the line for a touchdown. Once again, the game is tied, 5 minutes in the second.
You can hate me. You can hate me now. Do I hate now, you too. But I won't stop now. Come on. Come you on. Hate me now. Cause I can't stop now. Come on. You can hate me now. You can hate me now. Do it now. You can hate me now. Do it now. Toast, do it now.
Let's go.
And another touchback, and it is once again.
The last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field.
Tiger ball. They come out in a pistol, but it is not the full house this time. Etienne, the inside run, loses 2 yards after two defenders are there to meet him. Three, I'm sorry. Another run by Etienne, this time 7 yards up the gut out of a pistol twin tight ends. It's a shotgun wing offset on 3rd and 5. Green gets close, but not close enough. T. Higgins, 9 yards on a slot slant. Another handoff to Etienne and another loss of yardage on first down. Electing to go to the huddle, a rarity so far this game for the Tigers. They're going to send out 4 wide receivers.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down.
4 wide receivers still in a pistol, and Etienne still behind center. It's a screen. Henderson Jr. helps close the gap, and it's a 2-yard loss to make it 3rd and very long. And in response, the Tigers are going to deploy 11 personnel. Shotgun normal, halfback weak here. Time in the pocket, Overton. 15-yard out, catches it and steps over. An effective 3rd down conversion so far this game for the Tigers. Etienne outside left, and it's a 17-yard gain, bottled up eventually by the safeties. Hunter gets it off just before the tackle to T. Higgins, once again 7 yards this time. We continue to see more hurry up. And false start gives a timeout to the defense, and 5 yards, they'll take it. At least one of those fullbacks, maybe a tight end, is playing offensive line. Well, they're all up on the line because there's only one guy below. And Arnold, up a wide gap at center, gets 12 yards. And a run to the outside this time to Tim Arnold, and it's a 3-yard loss. Looks like we still have a fullback playing line as we see 4 wide receivers and a halfback. Johnson has out of the pocket. Contact with Henderson. It's a 6-yard scramble. It's now 3rd and 6. And it's a screen. Butts is there for the first touch. Travis Etienne is taken out after a 3-yard loss. That's a big defensive stand there to force the field goal. And Syracuse spend a timeout to save clock as Clemson puts up the field goal. Syracuse now has 1:52 to play. They've got two timeouts. Schumacher about 4 yards in the end zone, elects to take it out. Gets to the 18-yard line. 149, two timeouts, 82 yards to glory. Tanuvasa scrambling out. And the safety, Rob Koch, catches up with the streaking receiver to deflect the ball. Second and 10 now after a 4 second spend. Second and 10. It's a quarterback keeper. He gets it up the seam, and he's tackled down after 15. It's a good start, and we see no huddle. It's the shotgun wide trips. Tanuvasa scrambles out. He's being chased. He gets it to Lofton, who bounces off the sideline, comes back in, and is tackled just after the first down. 6 yards shy of midfield. Tanuvasa running down the edge. He beat one defender and it got him 25 yards on the scramble down the sideline. Heads up play there to step out of bounds just before the hit. Still a bit tired. Sending out the backup quarterback in five wide receivers. Tarkenton scrambling out and scrambling himself, gets 5 yards and out of bounds. The quarterback's number is 34 because coach was allowed to make it 34. The Syracuse Orange have a, I guess, unique numbering system. All of their quarterbacks are in the 30s. But he is not a dual position player, although he does get quite a lot of running yards. That's out of the scramble, and that's out of the option. Tanuvasa scrambles. He's bracketed. Throws the ball away. Third and five now on the opponent's 26 with 1:12 to go and two timeouts. Taking time in the huddle, getting everybody back up to rest it. Coming out of the huddle in the red. And they get the playoff just before the marker. And the defense closes on Tanuvasa before he can get the playoff. It's fourth and five now from the 26-yard line. And the Orange are going to send a kicking unit onto the field. It's going to be field goal for field goal here in the late second. Clemson's going to have just about a minute and three timeouts. An excellent long kick by Hoffrichter. .104 and three timeouts are what the Clemson Tigers have to work with. They're going to send 11 personnel. It's against three down linemen and a quarter defense from the orange. Tight end motions from left to right. And Green comes through for the sack. DeAndre Overton with the catch. He gets 12 yards and is hit out of bounds by the second man. It's 3rd and 5 now. Clemson spending one timeout. Etienne gets out left. He's getting around a lot of people and is hit out of bounds after a 29-yard gain. There's a reason Travis Etienne is a 99.
From the 41-yard line, first down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield.
And now the Tigers are in enemy territory. Green gets close, rushes the throw. Hunter Johnson throws it out of bounds. I keep wanting to say Hunter Thompson. I can understand that, Bouncer. I can't say I'm joining you, but I understand. 2nd and 10 now from the orange 41.
2nd and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line.
Johnson keeping it. He's hit as he throws. Overton catches it and is hit out of bounds. 3rd and 3 now at 42 seconds. Four wide pistol here at 3rd and 3. And there's a flag on the play after hitting the one in the back quarterback in the backfield, and they call it a face mask. That's a big gift to the offense. That's 15 yards when it would have been a loss of downs. 1st and 10 now from the 20.
And 10, ball on the 20-yard line. And down he goes, the 20-yard line.
Travis Etienne, the gut run, and call a timeout after no gain.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
And another running play to Etienne. And he gets 3rd and inches. Syracuse calls timeout. Each team now has one.
So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on 3rd down.
One of the tight ends switches sides. There's now one on each side of the ball. Etienne powers through 2 hits, gets 2 yards. And it's 1st and goal. 26 seconds.
They're crowding that line of scrimmage.
I do not know that off the top of my head. And he's out of the pocket, and that's a touchdown for Hunter Johnson.
Touchdown.
With 17 seconds left. Let's see, I think they lost the ACC championship game and then won a bowl game. That's one game. And then 14, 15, there, 8-0, so 23 games. Allworth elects not to return it.
Syracuse offense struggled in that first quarter, but man, they've really come to life here in quarter number 2.
17 seconds remain.
Just have their own defense try to come up with a
stop or two, they'd have the lead right now.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Tanevasa under center in an eye. Fakes a handoff. Throws to Bavaro, who gets out of bounds after 15 yards at the 40. Costs 5 seconds.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line.
From the right hash. Bavaro, another catch and out of bounds. This one for 10 yards. 9 seconds remain. And 13 yards this time. Another 3 seconds. 6 seconds remain in the quarter. They're on the 37-yard line. Shotgun spread flex here with 6 seconds. Handoff is to Neal. He gets 7 yards. And Syracuse call timeout with 2 seconds left. They're on the 30-yard line. And they send out the kicker. With 17 seconds left in the half, the Syracuse Orange steal 3 points.
I'd say the offensive coordinators definitely showed their wares in that first half. 31-27, Tigers. We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollock and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Syracuse is hanging around. They're clawing at their elbows and knees. They're scratching and fighting and trying to hang in there. And I think a lot of people would look at this, David, as an opportunity for a moral victory. Do you believe in moral victories?
To an extent. I mean, I think you can definitely take hope with a moral victory or take something from a moral victory. If you do it at the end of 60 minutes, right now it's 30 minutes. If you're down by 8 at the half, Reese, and then you get beat by 35, guess what everybody sees? You got beat by 35. So great start. Is it a moral victory for the first half? Yes, but I'm also within one possession and in a position to strike in the second half and possibly go win this bucket.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
I can understand the sentiment, bouncier, but I also think that, you know, frankly, the AI has a lot of kind of cheesy stuff that they do in a 2-minute drill that works a lot better than it usually should. So, you know, I think to a certain extent, all is fair in love and war, but I understand the argument. Quick look at some halftime stats here for you. It is not an 8-point, but it is a 4-point game here at the half, 31-27. Clemson leads. Similar amount of first downs and a similar amount of yardage so far. Both teams with an excellent running game. 24 runs for 211 yards for the Tigers, 16 runs for 177 yards for the Orange. Through the air, again, similar. For each of them, 133 and 148, 12 for 16, 15 for 18. A big difference so far is that Clemson is 7 for 9 on third down, whereas Syracuse is 1 for 3. On the one hand, the percentage definitely favors Clemson. On the other hand, Syracuse hasn't had to go for nearly as many. Both teams are 100% in the red zone and have no turnovers so far this game. Time of possession is within 20 seconds. some player stats here for you. Tommy Tanuvasa is 12 for 16 for 148 yards and one touchdown. That's 75% and an average of 12.3 gives him a rating of 173.3. Johnson is 15 for 18 on 133 and one touchdown. He's got 83%, but a shorter average of 8.8. He's got a 163.7 rating. On the ground, Travis Etienne is leading the way for the Tigers with 16 attempts for a 184. That's 11 yards average and one touchdown. Hunter Johnson has 6 for 18 yards. He's got 2 touchdowns on the ground. Those have been scrambles. Syracuse, Tommy Tanuvasa, the quarterback, leads the way on the ground with 153, including 2 touchdowns of his own. Mo Neal, the halfback, is 4 for 17. Through the air, Lofton leads the way with 6 for 68 and a touchdown. Bavaro is 3 for 38, mostly on those passes to end the quarter. Neal is 2 for 18, and Anoisi is 1 for 24. Clemson, Higgins, and Overturn are tied at 36 yards. Higgins has one more catch. Overton has a higher average. Etienne has some losses on the screen. Arnold is 2 for 11, and Beck actually has the most yardage at 37 here down the board, Lance Beck. Defensively, Baylon Spectre leads the way for the Tigers with 6 tackles, followed by Santonio Bush. For the Orange, Derek Thomas leads the way with 8 tackles, 3 for loss, and is tied actually with Henderson Jr., 8 tackles, 5 for loss. 1 sack so far this game for Kevin Green. And that's your halftime stats as we now return for the third quarter. Shotgun spread flex. Handoff is to Neal. He hits a 5-yard run. Well, as long as you're not lying on the tracks, Bouncier, you should be all right. Mo Neal with a 5-yard gain. It's now 2nd and 5. We're seeing a shotgun split big here. 4 down linemen. It's a quarterback keeper. There's a wide open gap. He's got great space. He's got yards and yards of space. And that's a huge 2nd and 5 run for 70 yards and a touchdown. You can get it if you really want. You can get it if you really want. You can get it if you really want. But you must try.
Succeed at last. I know it. Don't I show it? Don't give up now.
And with that, Syracuse have their first lead of the game. It's 34-31. It's now Tiger ball, 35 seconds into the third. A shotgun spread flex with a halfback on the left side. Johnson goes to Overton on the check down and muscles through, and there's a flag as well. And it's another face mask on the defense. That's going to be a 30-yard play. It's first and 10 now on the 42 of Syracuse. First and 10 from the 42. Two tight ends on the right, two wide receivers on the left. And Johnson throws the ball out of bounds. One of the tight ends playing slot now. Green motions from left to right. And it's another incompletion out of bounds to make it third and 10. And it's going to cause the Tigers to put five wide receivers onto the field. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. Fantastic tackle in space to prevent Beck from crossing the mark. And they're going to put a field goal unit on the field to see if they can tie it. Big play there by the defense. Important kick here. It's up. And it's good, but not by much. It's a tie ball game. And frankly, I think the Syracuse Orange are glad they escaped with only 3 points there after giving up a 30-yard play thanks to the penalty. Schumacher, deep in the end zone, takes the knee. Syracuse will now have the opportunity to get the lead once again. They haven't had the opportunity for a go-ahead move in quite a while. Well, actually, misspoke. Thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Shotgun spread flex. Handoff to Neal. Lots of space in the middle. He's tripped up when one of the defending linemen can turn around and grab a leg, but it's a 10-yard gain to the 35-yard line. And Ivasa waiting in the pocket, and Noisy is running across. He's hit back, and they call it a 1 yard gain. Second and 9 now. Comes out in the shotgun split big again. Two halfbacks, two tight ends. Quarterback keeper runs outside. Once again, lots of space and a blocker. It's a big one. And another massive run for Tommy Tanuvasa.
Tight game right here.
Syracuse gets set to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one.
And Clemson now on their own 25-yard line. Down 41-34. To Pistol Ace. Tight end motions. Two tight ends on the right. Johnson in the pocket. Chased from behind. And he's sacked for a loss of one. That was Troy Henderson Jr., the middle linebacker, coming around the long way. It's third and four now after the gut run by Etienne. And another run by Etienne, but he runs right into where a defender has the center locked down. And moves off him, gets Etienne, and that's going to force a punt. That is a three and out, and that's a big change of possession here. Halfway through the third quarter. Seven-yard return for Schumacher. The Clemson Tigers had 20 more yards than the Orange at the half. They are now 100 yards behind. It's a 120-yard deficit that's been made up in the last 3.5 minutes by Syracuse, and they add to it with 7 more yards from Mo Neal.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Shotgun Ace.
Is up by a touchdown.
Tanuvasa is scrambling out miles of space, and he circles back around to the hash marks and slides for a good big run.
So hard to stop. You have to scheme around him, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
And now, enemy territory. Metcalf out of the backfield in the shotgun split big. Gets 10 yards on the halfback angle. We're seeing a 3-3-5 now here from Syracuse as Tanuvasa keeps the ball in the read option. Gets 9 yards. Second and short now, every coach's favorite down and distance. It's on the 25-yard line of the Tigers. And it's a 2-yard gut run by Mo Neal. Gets 5 yards on a crossing drag. Second and 5 now from the 18-yard line.
Syracuse is up 7.
Tanuvasa doesn't like his looks, and he scrambles and slips between the defenders in the slides. It's first and goal now on the 10. Canavasa under center in the eye. It's a 4-3, maybe a 4-4 actually. Scrambles out, passes it to Richards, the fullback. Gets a 5-yard gain. First and goal now from the four. Sorry, second and goal now from the four. Five wide receivers. Lofton catches it and is pounced on by a safety. It's a 2-yard gain to third and goal from the 3-yard line. Five wide receivers again. Tanavasa scrambles. And he's sacked for a loss of 6. It's a big goal line stand there for the Clemson Tigers. It's going to be a 2-score game, but it's only going to be 10, not 14.
Syracuse is hoping to make this a 2-score game. Kicks up, and it is good.
A shallow angle makes it difficult, but Hoffrichter puts it right through. As we see the final in Virginia Duke. Duke taking down undefeated Virginia Cavaliers.
David and I thought this was impossible, but look what happened. A major upset is now complete.
Daniel Jones showing why he was picked in the first round of the draft by the New York Football Giants.
They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield.
No chance once again for a return as Clemson is now going to get the ball with 1:03 in the third. And off to Etienne. Unfortunately, the offensive lineman blocked the defender into the route of the run and really helped make sure that that was only a 1-yard gain as we see the hurry up again from the Tigers. Green, the tight end, gets 5 yards and is tackled immediately. Some audibles at the line of scrimmage for the Tigers. Expecting the run, Green on the short angle out, 22 yards to the tight end on the run commit. And Etienne attempting outside. And it's another flag on the tackle for loss. And it's another face mask. Champ Bailey this time. That is a lot of penalties. A lot of face masks in particular. And now that moves Clemson directly within field goal range even. And so, big penalty. Pistol full house again. The pass to Arnold. Arnold breaks a tackler. Gets 18 yards. Tackling to stop Travis Etienne, 6 yards. And Green, once again, just a second short. It's a 7-yard gain on the slant to first and goal. and defenders come through. Etienne loses 4 yards. Second and goal now from the 5.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
Thomas out, and once again Etienne loses yards. It's now 3rd and 7, I believe. 3rd and 8 to the goal line.
Let's see how the quarterback handles this one. It's 3rd and goal from the 7. Really one of the very tough places to play in college football, and it's no different today.
And it's a screen, Etienne. And it is blown up. It's 3 lost yards in a row for Etienne. And back-to-back-to-back defensive stands as the last 3 drives on both sides of the ball have resulted in kicks.
So it's 4th down. This should be an easy field goal. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here.
And it's up and good. It's a 7-yard, a 7-point game with 6.5 to go. Schumacher shallow in the end zone. Out of it and around to the left. Great blocking. He's past the 50. He's got one guy to beat. And Michael Schumacher, 90-yard return to the 17-yard line as he's tripped up by the kicker. I'm sorry, the 12-yard line tripped up by the kicker. Huge play. That was not the kicker. I'm sorry. Not the kicker. Somebody else. Tommy Tanevasa scrambles out of the pocket into green space and fumbles the ball, they say. They say that was a fumble. I'm not sure how the ball didn't cross the plane first.
Funny, because you usually don't see corners down there picking up loose balls. They're more worried about interceptions.
Yeah, I'm really not sure how the ball didn't cross the plane first. But no challenge from the sideline. Starting on the 25-yard line now, Clemson has a chance to tie. And Overton, 17 yards and out of bounds.
Nice throw to hit the out route against man coverage for a first down.
Travis Etienne running outside and back in on the seam. And another penalty. And another face mask. That's the 4th of the game. This one on Dave Butts.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. From the 37-yard line, first down.
It's an ace with twins left. Johnson in the pocket, scrambles, slides after a 3-yard gain.
Quarterback scramble gains 3 yards.
And some hurry up. Back to the pistol wing. Hand off to Etienne. He breaks some tackles, but stumbles to first down. Back-to-back handoffs to Etienne. A mile gash as he gets to the 18-yard rush that gets about to the 7. First and goal.
coming up on the line. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
And the penalty moves the goal. Moves the offense back and gives the chance for the defense to switch packages. Two fullbacks playing line as we see four wide receivers and one back, which is Arnold. Hand off to Arnold. It's hit after a 3-yard gain. And the Tigers want to stay with it. They don't go to the huddle. And it's a bad handoff as Hunter Johnson fails to hand off the ball. It's a failed handoff and it's a loss. Third and goal now from the 15.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
And the receiver has to come out of the end zone to get it. It's fourth and goal now from the 2, and the Tigers are going to go for it.
The offense is staying on the field. It's all or nothing. Here we go. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line.
And it is a handoff to Etienne. He is hit in the backfield, loses 3 yards, and that's a turnover. That's a huge defensive stop after the end zone fumble of their own. Tanuvasa with a mile the wide. That's a 96-yard touchdown run. Last year's Heisman winner, this year's Heisman leader, coming up big here in the second quarter, really to put his team on his back. Three of those Syracuse touchdowns are long, long runs by Tommy Tanuvasa. And now, into the wind, Clemson. 14 points down with under 4 minutes to go. A big turnaround there after the fumble. They attempt the read option. Etienne gets hit in the backfield. He recovers from the stumble. He's got great run blocking. Porter slows him down. He still muscles along and is at 280 yards rushing. That's a big run of their own. Now in the red zone. After just 30 seconds. Another handoff to Etienne. He goes outside. This time it's an 8-yard gain. Second and 2. Etienne loses a yard on second down, and he appears to be injured.
It can be very frustrating for a running back when he stopped before he even gets going.
Arnold in the game now. The handoff is to Arnold. And it's a 1 yard gain. Looks like a pistol full house again. And it's still Arnold. Arnold, Phillips, and Jackson now. Dislocated thumb. Hand off to Arnold. He's outside. And they call that short. That's another fourth down attempt that turns over in the red zone. Huge, huge defensive plays for the Orange. Tamu Vasa this time loses 3 yards as a defender closes right in on. Tanuvasa scrambles and stops, not with a lot of time, but Allworth is in the middle of the field with nobody near him. It's a broken defense that gets 60 yards. Shotgun split big here, and Tanuvasa loses 3 yards again. Clemson spending their last timeout. There's 2:05 remaining in the game. Second and 13 from the 43-yard line. Allworth is now injured. He's out for the rest of the game. Defensive coordinator anticipating this 5-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Tanuvasa scrambles. There's coverage. He throws it. Lofton comes across and gets 26 yards. Tanuvasa keeps on the read option, wide open, 17 yards and a touch. Clemson with the ball. They've got no timeouts. They've got just under 2 minutes, and they're down 37-58. Johnson waiting in the pocket. Looks, gets the check down. He breaks a tackle. He breaks a couple. And Travis Etienne with a 17-yard catch eventually taken down. Does not go down easy, Travis Etienne. And Edwards with the pick.
Nice interception and an even nicer vertical. Oh, yeah, this guy's a
5-yard gain on the quarterback keeper for Tommy Tuivasa starts the clock moving. Shotgun ace. Quarterback keeper on a read option. It's another 9 yards for Tuivasa. Five wide receivers. Three down linemen. Tuivasa scrambles out into space, 20 yards, 25 yards, and out of bounds. He's now at 470 yards on the ground for the game. And Bavaro late opening as Tuivasa extends the play by fading right. Less than a minute. And the wide receiver has broken the defense. Ooh, he's got one man to beat. Hudson coming in, pushes him out of bounds after a 47-yard gain by the tight end, J.J. Green. And for Johnson, he's now gone over 300 yards passing for the game. This young man really works at it, and it's always a boost to see that hard work reflected in the box score. He should be very pleased. And it's not too often you get a game like this from your quarterback, but it doesn't matter because these guys are still losing in the game. So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. And Johnson throws it out of bounds, stops the clock at second and 10. And hit as he throws, the pass goes to Chance Phillips. He gets 4 yards. Syracuse calls the timeout. We got a third and 6 here. Ball on 24. Slings it. And J.J. Green, they call it a catch. And it's a hurry up because that was not out of bounds. Although, Tigers have been playing hurry up all game. Clock is now live. And Johnson throws it out of bounds. Eighteen seconds in the game. And another incompletion out of bounds by Hunter Johnson. It's now third and 10. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers. So we're looking at another third down here. Thank you. And it's a screen. And Syracuse calls a timeout. It's 4th and 13 now with 8 seconds left to go. And defense deflects the ball and gets the turnover there. And that is the end of the game. Well, not quite. There's 4 seconds left to go. One play. It looks like they are going to run a play here. Tommy Tanuvasa, another running play, another great opening and good run blocking. But he gets bounced out of bounds after a 55-yard gain. That puts him over 500 yards for the game. That's an incredible game for Tommy Tanuvasa. I am sure he is the player of the game at this point, and especially of the second half. 525 yards rushing. A game that was close at halftime, and even despite 60 yards worth of penalties aiding the Clemson Tigers, they could not come away with the win. They lose 37-65. The number one, Syracuse Orange. It did take the Orange a while to get going, but eventually Tommy Tanuvasa understood that he was going to have to do it, and he did it to the tune of 525 yards on the ground. And 842 yards of offense, 573 on the ground, 525 of that by Tommy Tanuvasa. Great third down percentage. They were at 77% at the half. Yeah, got them on fourth and had barely any third downs of your own, and then eventually got the turnover, you won the turnover on downs battle by four. Great game, 20 for 24 for 269. But rushing, that's incredible. That's incredible. That's 525 yards and 6 touchdowns on the ground with a long of 96. He had 25 carries, he got 500 yards. That's a 21-yard average. 21-yard average. Lofton leading the way as the receiver, backed up by Bavaro and Allworth. Anderson Jr. leading the way, and one sack for Henderson and one sack for Kevin Green.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Thank you for joining us for this, the first half of our doubleheader this evening. We're going to follow this up in probably about 10-15 minutes with Navy at Notre Dame. Stay tuned for that. Number 18, Georgia goes down to Minnesota. And we will resume shortly.
We are just about set to get underway for the second game of our doubleheader. Navy at Notre Dame in League One's Game of the Week. Two teams with winning records but unranked looking to ascend up into the polls in a key non-conference rivalry game. Coach Ninja's here on hand. He's going to give you an inside look at Notre Dame's roster right now.
Avery Davis is the starting quarterback. He's a 91 overall junior. He's got speed, but he doesn't have agility and acceleration. He's got enough awareness to know that he's not good at running. So 196 yards a game through the air, 33 yards a game on the ground with a 3-yard rush. He doesn't try to rush. Now, we're lucky that Tony Jones Jr. is out, but Deion McIntosh is in. He's going to be very good as well. He's got great acceleration and speed. What he doesn't seem to have is size. He's still got 60 yards a game on the ground and none really through the air, which is good. I wonder, Jones, let's see, does this indicate... Okay, so they do go to Jones... when he was in, they went to Jones a little bit, so we expect a little bit to McIntosh through the air, but not a lot. Eric Harvey, not much to speak of. A lot of the offense goes to Williams, Harris, and Armstrong at all 40s and 30s, and Young is another 30, so they spread it around to four wide receivers, and Kmet gets 43. Nothing to speak of to Brock Wright. Got an excellent offensive line at 84, 94, 79 true freshmen, 90, 91. So even that 79 true freshman in the center, he's got plenty of help. Defensively, the ends are 91 and 87. Those are good. The tackles are 84 and 82. That's honestly as weak as it gets on defense. Left outside is 88, middle linebackers 91, 90, and right outside linebacker 90. They're all fantastic. The corners, first corner is an 89, second corner is an 86 impact player. Third corner, Kyle Green, is a freshman 80. He's still very good. 88 free safety and a 92 strong safety round out with an 81 kicker and an 88 punter, a really quite phenomenal team. With not a whole lot of weaknesses. We're going to try and take advantage of the fact that their starting halfback, Jones Jr., is out, but it's going to be a difficult game. This is a really good team. So without further ado, I'll hand it back, and we'll get kicked off.
Just about set to get underway for the second game of our doubleheader. Navy Notre Dame in the 91st meeting of a rivalry that goes back annually every year to 1927. The battle for the Red Miller Trophy sees a 97 overall Notre Dame team facing off against a 90 overall Navy midshipman squad. Going to be coming to you live from South Bend, Indiana, the home of the Linebacker Cafe and the College Football Hall of Fame. Liverpool and Dortmund, taking advantage of American fascination with European soccer, raking in the cash as they start their B teams on the field in South Bend. Just prior to this football game, we'll see if it affects the turf. Impact players for both teams, Perry, Rawls, and Lee for Navy. Jones, Love, and Komet for Notre Dame. Jones, of course, out with an injury. He'll miss this game with a broken finger. It is indeed a bright, sunny day in South Bend. It's been good weather all week as League One's college game day was set up in camp in South Bend this week for this game of the week. Notre Dame Stadium, one of the hallowed grounds of college football.
Right now, this club has done its part, taking care of its division so far, and hoping that that conference title is well within reach. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Live at Notre Dame Stadium. Looks like the field's in pretty good condition following that soccer game, the friendly between two European cash cows. Navy's going to get the ball to start. A couple of last minute adjustments here by Coach Ninja. And the midshipmen are going to be set to take over the football following the kickoff.
And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick.
We are underway here in Indiana. Out of the end zone it comes. Up to the 19-yard line. That's where the midshipmen will take over to open the football game.
An awfully emotional time. You always want to go out in style and get a win. Quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive.
Out of the huddle they come in a spread set. They've got five receivers out on the field. Notre Dame responds with a three-man front. Back to pass goes Hayes. Finds the crossing route to Richards. He picks up seven on first down. Going to be second and short.
Now with his wide receivers. He hit him for a nice game.
Bring up second and three.
Second and three as they break the huddle. 11 personnel for Navy, matching up against a four-man in front for the Irish. Navy taking their time, surveying the field. It's a read option play, and Hayes is wrapped up for a two-yard loss, now going to be third and five. Yard line, the marker. We're just about a minute into the football game here in the early going of a scoreless tie. Reggie Hayes brings his compatriots out onto the field. It's a shotgun set. Three receivers, four receivers, and a tight end. Caught by Amir Lee, the tight end. That's good enough for the first down. It's a 7-yard gain on third and five. That's going to set up Navy with a first and 10 on their own 30-yard line. Hayes comes out of the huddle. It's a familiar formation for Navy fans. It's the eye tight, twin tight end set. Malcolm Perry, superstar stud in the backfield for the midshipmen. He gets the handoff. They're going to call it no gain. He may have gotten a half a yard, but it is going to be second and 10 as Navy goes no huddle, trying to catch the Irish off guard. Sticking with the eye tight, Notre Dame staying with a four-man front. Again, Navy trying to take the air out of the game. Lets the clock run down. throws it short, but it's broken up. Now going to be third and long.
Quarterback did a nice job of reading the defense, puts the ball in a position to be able to make the catch. Problem is the wide receiver did not focus and concentrate and hold on to the ball.
From their own 30-yard midshipmen coming out in a spread set. They've got five receivers. Notre Dame still with a four-man in front. Looks like just two linebackers and a nickel set. Back to pass goes Hayes, looking. Oh. It's intercepted by Robertson on the opening drive, and Notre Dame's going to have excellent field position on their opening drive as they're going to take over on Navy's 40-yard line. To open Notre Dame's first possession, they're going to come out in 11 personnel. Navy responding with a 4-3 under. Quick pass out into the flat. Jalen Harris picks up two on the first down play. Now second and eight as Notre Dame goes no huddle. The pass to Komet, the tight end for Notre Dame, picks up the first down. It's an 8-yard catch, just enough to get beyond the marker. As Notre Dame now with a fresh set of downs on the 30-yard line, stays with a no huddle. Navy stays with the 4-3 under. Notre Dame still with 11 personnel. Davis drops back and calls a draw play, but the Navy defense has got enough bodies there, and Deion McIntosh only picks up one. Now going to be second and nine. Screen pass out to the right side. It's deflected at the line. Good pressure by Navy caused that pass to fall harmlessly to the turf. Now going to be third and nine. Shotgun set. Bunch to the left for Notre Dame, hits the flag route, and Jafar Armstrong picks up 20 yards on the third down play. Not going to be first and goal barely. It's at the 9.5-yard line as the Irish continue to go no huddle. Taking some time for the quarterback to get up to the line. He was hit at the end of that play, but he's able to hand it off to McIntosh, and Deion McIntosh picks up two. Once again on first down, second and goal from about the 7.5. Man in motion for the Irish. Davis back to pass and finds his man on the slant route. Deion McIntosh, the halfback, actually that might have been an angle route coming out of the backfield, picks up the touchdown, and Notre Dame takes the early lead, 6-0, awaiting the extra point.
Six-point lead. He makes the PAT. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
The Ducks came into the game ranked 10.
The big top 10 score there you just saw. Stanford upsetting Oregon. I call it an upset because it was at Autzen Stadium at the Autzen Zoo in Eugene, Oregon.
He's to the 20.
Good kickoff return by Malcolm Perry. Picks up 39 yards on the return. He's going to set up Navy with pretty decent field position, as they're going to take over well outside their 30. They're going to mark it at 37.
They moved the ball down, put points on the board. Now it's just more about trying to maintain what they've already created.
Out of the huddle come the midshipmen once again in the spread set. Five receivers as Notre Dame responds with a four-man front. Looks to be about a dime formation there for the Irish. They hit the secondary receiving option. Good read by Reggie Hayes, finds Reggie Henry. Reggie to Reggie, picks up good yardage and a first down for the midshipman. ball now into Notre Dame territory for the first time today on Navy's second drive. Shotgun wide trips. Hayes in the backfield along with Malcolm Perry as the midshipman attempts to tie this football game. It's a handoff up the gut to Perry. He picks up good yardage. A couple of shifty moves is going to leave them with the second and one. Every coach's favorite down and distance. An opportunity for Navy to call a play that could set something up later.
Second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Eye tight. Navy's favorite formation. Perry in the backfield. Hayes under center. It's an ISO run to Hayes up the gut. Sorry, to Perry up the gut. He picks up good yardage. Going to be a first and 10 on the 27. Navy driving. Shotgun wide trips for the midshipmen. 11 personnel. Notre Dame responds with a four-man front once again. Back to pass goes Hayes. Under pressure, but gets the throw away. Perry makes the reception for a 7-yard gain on first down. And Navy 9 feet away from a fresh set of downs.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
They're going to come out with twin tight ends once again, this time in the split big shotgun set. Reggie Hayes machinations at the line of scrimmage, audibling, reacting to the defense. It's a quarterback keeper, but he's swallowed up by multiple defenders. It's going to be a loss of a yard. That's going to bring up third and four. They're just outside the 20 at about the 21-yard line. That's where they're going to mark it, facing this third down play. Two minutes and change remaining in the first frame as Navy breaks the huddle for this big third down play on their second drive. 11 personnel, shotgun set as Hayes takes the snap. Drops back, looks, finds his halfback Perry over the middle, but he's short of the first down. Going to be a 3-yard gain when they needed four. Now going to be fourth and one on the 19-yard line here in the early going. Navy's going to send out the kicking unit. In League One, you're allowed 12 fourth down attempts. Navy's got a handful, as does a number of teams this year. We are past the halfway point. And the midshipmen looking to save a couple of fourth down attempts for later use. Put their first points on the board, the hardest points to get. Big score there in Big Ten play. Michigan State coming up with a 24-21 win. They're now 6-2. One of those losses to one of our users, Seawack, the head coach of Indiana University, trying to compete for that Eastern Division crown. That's an impactful result for him as Michigan takes the loss in that rivalry game. Rawls puts the ball deep into the end zone near the end line. And the catch results in a foot out of bounds, an automatic touchback. 7-3, Notre Dame with a minute and a half remaining in the first quarter.
They punched it in for six on the last series. Can they do it again?
Notre Dame comes out with three wide receivers to the right and a tight end to the left. It's a handoff to McIntosh, but the defense is there. They have three personnel there. The first one makes the tackle. Going to be a loss of three. Now second and 13. Nice opening play there on the drive for the Navy defense. Going to set up Notre Dame with a difficult situation here already. Second and 13 on their own 22.
From their own 22-yard line, it's second down.
Notre Dame out of the huddle in a shotgun set, tight end to the left. Back to pass is Davis. Hits the curl route to Harris. He breaks the first tackle. Second defender gets him, but not before he picks up 17 yards. And Notre Dame goes no huddle. Under center this time. Davis back to pass. No, it's a draw play. McIntosh tries to break the first tackle. Unable to completely break it. He gets forward a couple of yards before the second defender stops him for a gain of six. Now second and four as the Irish continue with the no huddle attack. Navy in a 4-3 under. Pass to the left on another curl route to Harris. He picks up 10. It's a fresh set of downs for the Irish. They're just inside Navy territory at about the 43-yard line. Man in motion. Tight end goes from left to right. Davis tries. Look, I don't know if that was a shovel pass or a draw play. Kind of a quasi-run, quasi-pass, but it gets 3 yards. Now going to be second and seven as the Irish continue the no-huddle attack. Davis back to pass. Halfback picks up the block, and Komet picks up the catch. It's going to be good enough for 5.5. That results in third down, 1 yard to go from the Navy 35-yard line. It's an option play. McIntosh gets the ball on the pitch, runs around to the right side, picks up 10 yards. That's going to be the final play of the first quarter as Notre Dame holds the ball and the lead 7-3 over the midshipmen here in the first half.
Set to resume action here in the second quarter.
They break the huddle to start the second quarter. And Notre Dame coming out in a twin tight end set. Left tight end offset, and he comes in motion. And they run to the right and then cut back on a counter play up the gut for a 4 yard gain for Deion McIntosh. Now second and six as the Irish continue in their no huddle set. Now fully twin tight ends. Wide receiver in motion this time. Davis back to pass looking. Throws out of the back of the end zone. Doesn't want to throw it into coverage and just chucks it deep. Now going to be third and six. Navy comes out in the dime set. Notre Dame with 11 personnel. Three wide receivers and a tight end. They hit Armstrong. He's tackled for a gain of 5. He's short of the first down. And we'll see what Notre Dame wants to do here. They're going to go for it. This is not Notre Dame's normal MO. They are a conservative coaching staff. They would normally kick a field goal. But in this case, they're going to come out for fourth down. Navy comes out in the goal line set. They're going to sell out on the run. Notre Dame with twin tight ends to the left. It's a handoff up the gut. It's a stop on fourth down. And just like that, Navy takes over possession with possibly a slight edge in momentum despite trailing. Trailing 7-3 here in the early stages of the second quarter. Navy coming out with a spread set, single back. It's the give to Perry up the gut. He's got good space to work with. He picks up 15 yards on the carry. That's going to take him to 4 carries with a 7.3-yard average. He's already up to 29 yards.
We've got a first and 10. 33-yard line.
It's the eye tight twin tight end set for Navy. Four down linemen for the Irish. First and 10, Navy football, trailing by 4. Hayes drops back to pass, hits Lee on the crossing route. He picks up 3 on the left side of the field. Now going to be second and 7. We're under the 7-minute mark here in the second quarter.
Line.
36-yard line, left hash is the marker for the Navy offense. They're facing a second and seven. They've got a shotgun normal halfback weak. It's a handoff to Perry up the gut. He picks up two, now going to be third and four. Yard line, the marker. Hayes in the shotgun set. Back to pass he goes, looking, finds his man over the middle. McKinley picks up 7 yards on the slant from left to right across your radio dial. That's good for a Navy first down. Right near midfield, they're out to their 45-yard line and driving. Navy coming out in the shotgun split big. Notre Dame, 4 down linemen. Hayes gives it up the gut. Malcolm Perry picks up 6. And just like that, it's 2nd and 4. Just across the midfield stripe, 1 yard into Notre Dame territory. 2nd and 4 for Navy. And Perry, tackled for a 2-yard loss, is going to bring up 3rd and 7. Navy breaks the huddle with a spread set. Notre Dame trying to respond has multiple defensive backs on the field. Back to pass goes Hayes. Hits the underneath man. He falls forward. Todd McKinley picks up just enough for the first down, and it's a fresh set of downs for the midshipman. 4 minutes, 28 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Shotgun split big. Hayes fakes the handoff, gets the pitch off. Perry with a spin, gets an extra yard and a half, picks up 7. A lot of things could have happened on that play, but 7 yards is what did happen. Navy goes no huddle now, taking Notre Dame off guard possibly. They get the pitch off just in time. It's a great pitch by Perry, results in a big gain by Bright. That's a 31-yard gain by Joe Bright, the second halfback for Navy, as Hayes gets the pitch off just in time. He was about to be tackled for a yard loss, but he's able to get the pitch away as two tacklers descend on him and leave the edge open for Bright. First and goal now on the 6-yard line, Navy in the shadow of Notre Dame's goalposts. The spread set, single back formation. Hand off to Perry up the gut, and he's into the end zone. And that is the first lead of the ball game for the midshipmen. Ahead 9-7, awaiting the extra point. Kick by Rawls goes out of the back of the end zone. Navy takes their first lead 10-7, 3:33 on the clock as the Irish take over in their home stadium.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Out to the left goes McIntosh. Can't break the tackle on the edge, but he does pick up six. Clock running, but Notre Dame sticking with their no-huddle attack, something they've been using for much of the game today. McIntosh to the right this time. Defender keeps him from gaining too much yards. He only picks up one. Now going to be third down, 3 yards to go. That's right, Blitzkrieg. We could use a few more down periscope references for Navy. Komet on the flag route picks up 10. It's a short flag route, but it is a flag route. Picks up the first down for the Irish. Davis in the backfield in a shotgun set. Drops back, looking. Finds Komet again. Back-to-back passes to the tight end. Cole Komet picks up 8. Now second and short. 2.5 minutes before the halftime break. Handoff up the gut to McIntosh. He was slow to get going. Looked like he had pudding in his shoes as he was able to get no forward momentum and easily tackled for a 1 yard loss. Man in motion right to left. It's an option play to McIntosh out to the right side, and team tackling brings him down after a 13 yard gain on the right side as Notre Dame moves the ball down to Navy's 38 yard line. We are just about at the 2 minute mark in the first half here in this tight ball game.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38.
Davis in a shotgun set. Tight end goes in motion left to right. Davis back to pass. Hits a diving Jafar Armstrong for a 19 yard gain. And they're into Navy's red zone at the 19, 1:46 on the clock. Navy comes out in a goal line set. They're determined to stop the run for the Irish. We'll see what happens as the tight end goes in motion. Davis back to pass, has to scramble. Breaks the tackle, runs to the right, and he's pushed out of bounds after a 17-yard gain. The Irish now have the ball inside the 5-yard line. It's going to be first and goal from about the 2.5, depending on where they spot it. Looks like they spotted it on the 3. This announcer thinks it should be the 2. It is, in fact, the 2 where they spot it. First and goal from the 2-yard line for the Irish. Goal line set for Navy. Goal line set for Notre Dame. It's a toss play to the right. Sorry, to the left. And Deion McIntosh waltzes in. He's got plenty of green space as Notre Dame retakes the lead, 13-10, awaiting the extra point. Kick is up and good, and it's a 4-point game. 96 seconds before the halftime break.
So our score, 14-10. Notre Dame is ready to kick it away. Excellent kick.
Kick goes 7 yards into the end zone, and Manson content to take the touchback. Navy will take over on their own 25 in the middle of the field with 3 timeouts and 96 seconds. Out of the huddle they come in the familiar eye tight.
So I think diversity is the key for them moving into the second half. They've got to be able to try to make some changes, put the pressure.
Hayes surveys the field. It's a play action pass. He's sacked for a loss of 7. Now going to be second and 17. 1:32 on the clock and counting. Navy at this point has to consider the value of going for points before the half versus the possibility of Notre Dame getting the ball one more time before the break.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Second and 17, and Navy's going to go for it. They've got five wide receivers out there calling an aggressive play here on second down. They'd love to get points. They want to get points. They're going to fight for it. Hayes looks back to pass. He's almost sacked, but he gets the ball away, and despite the fact that he was hit as he threw, the ball was unaffected on the throw. It is an accurate throw despite the contact, and it's good for a first down for the midshipman. 57 seconds on the clock. Hayes sacked for 8 yards. 52 seconds remaining. Defense. 13 of those count off the clock before they break the huddle. Now 34 and counting. Maybe coming out in the shotgun split big. It's a quarterback keeper. Hayes is off and running. I don't know if the Notre Dame's defense is going to be able to catch him. This could be a big play right before the half. It is the shotgun split big. And Reggie Hayes takes it into the end zone with 5 seconds. It looked like Navy was going to play it conservative. They were planning on playing it conservative. They would have been happy to play it conservative. But the result of the play is a huge touchdown with just 6 seconds before the half. Navy takes the lead. That's 7 points when there was only 24 on the board. A huge play in the context of the game that could come back to haunt the Irish.
The return team looks ready to go. They need
calls a running play, happy to end the half. They get the first down. Looks like they did call a timeout. They're going to have time to run one more play before the halftime break. The midshipmen holding a 17-14 lead here in South Bend, Indiana. Davis chucks it way deep, way high in the air, and it's deflected. It looked like about 6 guys got their hands on it, but it falls harmlessly to the turf, and we've reached the halftime break with Navy ahead by 3.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show. Presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being. And we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a
soccer player, please?
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herbstreit's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, we've got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
We see some halftime stats there. 213 yards for Notre Dame, 183 for Navy. Notre Dame leading by 40 yards, but of course they've had one extra possession due to the turnover. The one turnover of the game, an early miscue by Navy, but they rebounded to take the lead right before the half. You see Navy 4 out of 5 on third downs. Notre Dame 3 out of 5. Both teams fairly balanced. 15 runs for Notre Dame, 11 passes. 14 runs for Notre Dame, 15 passes. 15 runs for Navy, 11 passes for the midshipmen. And with that, we are just about set to get the second half underway. Notre Dame's going to receive the kickoff. Navy has the lead.
All aboard!
Rawls puts it beyond the end line, and Notre Dame's going to take over on their 25. Both teams break the huddle as we get the second half underway. Quick pass out to the right side, broken tackle, two broken tackles. The third one gets him, but not before Jafar Armstrong picks up 20 yards on the screen pass to the wide receiver position. Irish continuing with their no-huddle attack. Navy in the 4-3. It's a fake handoff. He throws across his body. And he's lucky it wasn't picked. It counts for a 3-yard gain to Jafar Armstrong. That was an ill-advised throw as the quarterback panicked a little bit as he rolled out to the right. Davis perhaps a little bit unnerved by the Navy defense. It's a draw play this time to Deion McIntosh. He picks up 5. Now going to be 3rd down, 3 yards to go. Handoff up the gut to McIntosh, gets the first down, and Navy has to reset on defense as Notre Dame continues to march forwards. They stay with the no huddle, shotgun, 11 personnel. Navy in there 4-3. It's a counter run. McIntosh starts to the right and then cuts back left, makes the cut and gets 6 yards on first down. Now going to be 2nd and 4. Hand off to the right to McIntosh. Two tacklers meet him at the first down marker. They hold him short of the first down. Not going to be another 3rd down. It's 3rd and inches on the Navy 32-yard line. Notre Dame trails the midshipmen by 3 here in the 3rd quarter.
Third and a foot. Ball on the 32.
Notre Dame elects to come out spread. They've got 3 receivers to the left and 1 to the right. Option play, good enough for the first down. Kyle Smith picks up 3 on the pitch. Fresh set of downs for the Irish. They stay with the no huddle attack. Davis in the shotgun set. He's got his halfback to his left. It's a quick pass out to the left. Young picks up about 2 yards. Now going to be 2nd and 8. Shotgun set for the Irish. Davis, quick pass out to the right. This time, Navy's defense has personnel there. Going to result in a 4-yard loss for Jafar Armstrong. And now it's 3rd and long. Opportunity here for Navy to go to the huddle, get a little bit of rest, and possibly change their personnel package for this third and long play. They're going to come out in the 3-3-5 across. Notre Dame coming out with 11 personnel. Davis back to pass, looking, goes for the screen pass. Breaks the tackle and gets the first down. Two tackles broken, and McIntosh gets 12. He needed 11. Shotgun set for Davis. Man in motion. Williams moves a little bit inside on the right side. Doesn't get the pitch off. It's a 3-yard loss as Navy's defense penetrates the backfield and stops the play in its tracks. Now second and 13. Another opportunity for Navy to catch a breather. Change up their play calling just a little bit. They're going to continue with the 3-3 personnel, 3-3-5 personnel, but this time it's a split set. Facing off against this Irish shotgun formation. Davis throws to the right. A couple of receivers there, but the ball falls harmlessly to the turf. Looks like maybe the receivers got in each other's way a little bit. Now going to be third and long once again on this drive. The Irish break the huddle. They've got four receivers out to the right, including the tight end. Davis goes for the corner route and gets another first down. That's another third down conversion for the Irish on a 14-yard pass. That's Brock Wright's first catch of the game. And it finds the Irish in the shadow of Navy's goalposts, facing first and goal from about the six. Back to pass goes Davis, goes to the left to Komet. Cole Komet, the tight end, picks up 4 yards on first and goal. Now going to be second and goal from the two. Navy going 3-3-5 bear. Notre Dame staying in the shotgun set. Handoff up the gut to Young, finds pay dirt, and Notre Dame retakes the lead, 20-17, awaiting the extra point.
Plays 74 yards,
almost half of the third quarter, and Notre Dame leads by 4 as they kick off to the midshipman. Manson takes the ball 1 yard into his end zone and brings it out, goes for the return. He's got good blocking to the left side. He's beyond the 45-yard line. Going to be excellent field position for the midshipman after a 48-yard return by Manson. Navy comes out trailing by 4, but already near midfield. Shotgun wide trips. Over the middle they go. They pick up a few yards. It's 3 on first down on the drag route from right to left across your radio dial. The ball at the midfield stripe. We're here in the third quarter coming to you live from South Bend, Indiana, in this 91st meeting of a rivalry that dates back to 1927. The midshipmen with their familiar twin tight end eye tight set. Back to Pasco's Hayes on the drag route, picks up 4 to Reggie Henry. Now going to be third down, 3 yards to go. 9 feet for a first down for the midshipman.
Here's third and 3.
Third down, 3 yards to go. Navy with five wide receivers. Hayes drops back to pass, throws to the left side. Good enough for the first down. McKinley falls forward for an extra few yards. Picks up 15 yards on the play. It's going to be a fresh set of downs for the midshipmen in Irish territory. Inside the 40 they go to about the 33, 32-yard line.
First and 10. Ball on the
31. 31 is where they'll spot it. Navy breaks the huddle in the shotgun split big. Hand off up the gut, picks up three. Malcolm Perry on the carry. He's got 51 yards rushing. He's got 5.1 yards per carry. Perry off to a good start for the midshipman. They're going to go no huddle and stay with the split big. Notre Dame responding with four down linemen. Caught out of the backfield, the second halfback, Joe Bright. He had a big 30-plus yard run earlier. He picks up a nice 6-yard catch here. Not going to be third and short for the midshipman.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down.
Third and two, the ball spotted at the 23-yard line as Navy breaks the huddle and the shotgun wide trips. Hayes drops back, finds Perry out of the backfield. He's got the first down and a 5-yard catch, and Navy gets a chance to reset here in the closing moments of the third quarter in a 4-point ball game.
From the
18-yard line, right hash is where the ball is. Shotgun split big. Notre Dame with a 4-man front. Keeper by Hayes. He pitches it to Perry, to Bright. Joe Bright picks up 8 on the first down play. That's the triple option. Highly successful. Gets 8 yards. Now second and short. 10-yard line, the marker. We've got 1 minute remaining in the third frame.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Eye tight formation. Navy with twin tight ends. Up the gut to Perry. He picks up enough. No, they're going to call him short. Looked like he had enough. It's going to be third and inches, and Navy trying to catch Notre Dame off guard goes no huddle. Big third and inches play coming here. It's the give to the fullback up the gut, and Leonard Scott picks up 3 on the fullback dive. Notre Dame not ready for that play, and it's good for the first and goal from the 5-yard line as we approach the end of the third quarter. First and goal from the 4.5. Navy comes out in a shotgun wide trips. Perry on the give up the gut. He's into the paint, and Navy retakes the lead. 23-21, awaiting the extra point.
Thank you.
kickoff goes well into the end zone. Notre Dame takes the touchback, and they'll start from their own 25, trailing by three with just 4 seconds before the final frame. First and 10, they'll probably get one play and one play only before we enter the fourth quarter. Man in motion left to right. Give up the gut to McIntosh. He picks up six. And that's going to end the third quarter. As we go to the final frame, Navy holds a three-point lead. Davis in a shotgun set. Man in motion, left to right. Shotgun pass, and he's sacked. Avery Davis goes down for a loss of eight as Joe Sapp enters the backfield and makes a statement, bringing the quarterback down for a loss of eight. Now going to be third and a mile. Davis looking, runs the screen pass. McIntosh breaks the tackle, but not the second and third. It's going to be a stop by the Navy defense. That is a three and out just when they needed it, leading by three in this tight game. Navy breaks the huddle in the fourth quarter, ahead by three, with good field position at their own 34. Read option, he's tackled for a gain of one. Now second and nine from the 34. Hayes, back to pass, finds his man Perry out of the backfield. He picks up seven, now going to be third and two. 6 minutes, 20 seconds remaining on the game clock.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers.
Navy goes five wide receivers. Hits the drag route, complete for the first down and more. Vince Richards picks up 11 on the play. They only needed a couple. It's going to be a fresh set of downs for Navy in Notre Dame territory when they snap the ball on the next play.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 48.
48-yard line, the marker. Navy ahead by three, lining up in the shotgun split big. Hayes on the keeper, has some room, picks up the first down for 11 yards. That takes him to 60 yards rushing. and it gives Navy a first down at Notre Dame's 37. They're knocking on the door of scoring range.
From the 37-yard line, it's first down.
They're going to come out in the shotgun split big again.
Navy is up a field goal.
And Notre Dame a little bit more prepared for it that time. They hold him to 4 yards. Reggie Hayes falls forward on the play. Now 2nd and 6. We're approaching the halfway point of the fourth quarter. Navy with the lead in the football. The give up, the gut to Perry. Just shy of the first down. Going to be 3rd and 1 when they come back out of the huddle, as we're going to cross the midway point of the fourth quarter. Third and one. Navy back out in the 5 wide. Hits the slant route. Henry able to hang on despite tight coverage. Looked like Notre Dame was almost ready for that middle slant. But Navy able to pick up another first down using it. Midshipman coming out in the eye tight. Twin tight end set. Give up the gut to Perry. He picks up good yardage. Navy had gone away from the ISO for a little while. Able to come back to it here and pick up the first down. Now going to be 1st and goal from the 10. Navy attempting to take a 2-score lead here late. First and goal from the 10. Give up the gut to Perry. He's got good running room and he's into the paint. It's a touchdown for the midshipmen and they take the 9-point lead, awaiting the extra point. Extra point is up and good, and Navy holds a 10-point lead. There's 159 seconds on the clock. Notre Dame now running out of time. Notre Dame comes out with 4 wide receivers and 1 halfback. 2:39 remaining. It's another sack Avery Davis goes down. Now going to be second and 17. It was a sack that ended Notre Dame's drive last time. Another sack here. And Navy putting the pressure on the Irish. Davis able to get rid of the football, but that is the definition of a throwaway. It's going to bring up third and a mile, 17 yards to go for the Irish. Davis goes deep and cashes in the lottery ticket for a 51-yard gain. 2:03 remaining, and Notre Dame not quite ready to give up yet. Catches the ball, gets out of bounds with 1:58 remaining. We're inside 2 minutes, so that's going to stop the clock.
Yard line,
the marker. Davis in shotgun formation. Ball caught for 5 yards, out of bounds, takes 4 seconds off the clock. 1:54 remains. Notre Dame on Navy's 11-yard line. Davis in a shotgun spread, surveys the field, and it's an interception on the play, and it looks like he got a foot in before he goes out of bounds. Hansen comes up with a monster play for the Navy defense. That's the second time this season that a late interception by Navy has enabled them to hang on in a close run game. They're going to take over the football, leading by 10. Notre Dame's going to be forced to use some timeouts here. Perry on the carry, picks up 5. That's the first timeout for Notre Dame. The running play forces the Irish to use one of those timeouts. The timeout stops the clock. Gives everybody a rest on both sides of the ball. Navy breaks the huddle here, facing second and 5. Hand off to Perry. Results in a loss of 1. Now going to be 3rd and 7. And with a 2-score lead, you have to believe that Navy is better served by getting Notre Dame to spend their final time out. The last thing they want is a turnover deep in their own territory. Third down and 7. Ball on the 8. Shotgun split big. Four down linemen for the Irish. Fakes the give. Hayes keeps it and gets the first down. He falls forward. He had about 3 yards after contact there, and that could be the ball game. There's only 1:38 on the clock, and the clock will move as soon as the referees respot the ball. Check that. Notre Dame's timeout is going to prevent that from happening. It does stop the clock, but Navy in a commanding position.
Up about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 22-yard line, second down.
Here we go. Ready? Red 18! Red 18!
So we're looking at another third down here. He's tackled at the 29.
Makes it first and 10.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. If you're an offensive coordinator, you love this play. His quarterback will take a knee. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 31-21. Navy. As we finish up the broadcast, what do you have to say about how this game turned out, Kirk?
It was a good game, but I'm sure there's a little disappointment down there. Notre Dame had a few missed opportunities in this game, and I think if they could have capitalized on a few of them, it would have been a lot closer, and they might even have won this game.
EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. This is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.